Hey guys, it's Myriad and thank you for tuning back in. We're back again with a second of Keith Thompson's books. This time it's 50 Robots to Draw and Paint. If I remember rightly, this is one of the books I picked up again back in 2011-2012-ish when I was drawing on a laptop with a tablet and trying to get into digital art. It's a book I've kept hold of again because just like the fantasy vehicle book, we've got entries by different artists as well, but he also goes into expanding the world the robots live in, what they do, why they do it, who they do it for, and he also covers a lot of the idea building, sourcing of information, the construction sort of information again at the start of the book. So, very well-loved book. Postscript. You may want to destroy all your art when the robot uprising occurs, as these insensitive mechanist caricatures will be greatly frowned upon. So, make note of that, guys, before you carry on with the rest of the book. And again, we go through collecting inspiration, blocking out drawing and research, where you can find your inspiration from. Even if it's just within the book, you've got plenty in here. In our traditional expanding on the digital media, this is a later book if I remember rightly, although some of the pictures might be familiar. And then working through different methods, different techniques to bring out the detail. All your different rendering techniques for different surfaces. Annotated process and our colours, and you end up with a robot with a brain and a big gun. Playing with your ideas or other people's ideas. Together so you can work out how they come apart. Iterations. He looks familiar. Like he was predicting the future. I wonder how many of you guys have had something delivered by an Amazon drone or Uber Eats delivery robot. Yeah, like the other book, we're just playing with shapes and ideas and coming up with our robots. And as we move on, so cool. We'll start developing military robots. So this always made me think of what H.R. Giger would sketch if he was working on a series like Bubblegum Crash or Bubblegum Crisis. Nice little caster wheels. If you couldn't tell, this is Keith's work. Fantastic style of drawing that he has. Suicide drone. Cybernetic soldier. The Hephaestus anvil. His art style is so cool. And there's more of his work on his website that will be linked in the description below. People just, there are people who just sit there and come up with these ideas and concepts. Okay. Like I breathe, they just pop ideas like this out. And all the work before these ideas fully take shape. Grunter. Nakatomi clerk. Don't see many of these at the plaza. Off-world trader. And of course, municipal enforcement droids. And this little blurbs. The Marshal Queller. Encyclical purger, because human zealots aren't enough, anthropic robots in force on a pogrom are even more terrifying. The globalized unified church and its unstoppable robot army. Orbital delegates. I still like the IG droid. Bounty Hunter Shook 300. Samurai Guard. Now, see, this is a design concept that I'd be against because it's already got a disembodied head. An assistant robot with more than one pair of hands, because we all need more than one pair of hands. Adjuve Mark IV. And more Japanese inspired gloriousness by Keith. So this is a clay golem that takes inspiration from Jewish mythology, I believe. Where is it? Rising its work is with the spark of life. Removing part of the inscription to activate the golem. I can't remember. Hmm. witch puppets. Ah. And for when you have everything you need, definitely need a gentleman gardener to do lengths of your garden. A little bit too human for it to be Fallout, but a very similar idea. Gotta love the sort of 50s, 60s deco retro future design. And that's it, guys. So yeah, another great book with lots of technique and inspiration, lots of guides for gathering information before you start putting pencil to paper, the sort of stuff you should explore, and another glorious book by an incredible artist. I highly recommend you check out his website and his other stuff. Thank you for tuning in, and catch you in the next video.